Gabe came up with this idea for Michael, Shane, and I to have a street fight.
Well, anything that's involved, tables, and ladders, and chairs, all this stuff. So, of course, my mind starts just swirling with creativity, like, oh, what can we do? And this
ring of big kick.
And we went out there and just beat the fuck out of each other.
They're looking to whip him in reversal.
That was really a stepping stone for me to be able to show what I could do in a creative sense, you know, because I was running up a ladder in the corner and flipping onto him. And to my knowledge, that was the first time Please Don't Die was ever even mentioned.
Listen to fans.
So I take a lot of pride in that. You know, I'm climbing this bent ladder. Gabe on the commentary was like, oh my God, do you hear that? Most wrestling fans pray for these guys to get hurt. They don't care about these guys' well-being, but these guys really do care about these guys' well-being. They've earned that respect from the fans. Nah.
He doesn't really talk like that. Sort of does. It's kind of similar.
I don't think the ladder can so... Paul London nails a beautiful shooting star press from 15 feet in the air off of that wobbly ladder.
And I remember getting to the back and this guy, Tony Mameluke, he was like, man, you guys just cemented your spots here. That was fucking awesome. The crowd was chanting, you know, match of the year.
Nothing speaks like a crowd chanting match of the year and five-star match.
That's a special thing, I guess, you know, when these fans are so bloodthirsty and they want to be there to say, oh, I was there that night, so-and-so was paralyzed, or I was there that night, I got blood all over me, or, you know, and you could think of that as kind of sickening in one way, but to think of the complete opposite of, you know, I really didn't want him to be hurt, and I was really concerned for him. I mean, then you got him at that point. You really got these people, you know what I mean? And that was just such a feather in our caps. I couldn't have asked for a better dance partner in that match. He just made me such a better wrestler, psychology-wise, too. As much as I love Ivan Putski, that was something that he really did not help us with, psychology. You know, it was more so just technique. But as far as the psychology, I really credit Rudy Boy Gonzalez and Michael Shane for helping me with a bunch of that, you know, as far as when to do these moves and why. You know, it's one thing to be taught that from a coach, but it's another thing to be taught that from the guy you're in the ring with. Up until that point, it was more so, I'm gonna do some stuff to you, and then you do some stuff to me, and then I'll do some stuff to you, and you do some stuff to me.
You can do a million moves in the world, but if no one cares about those moves, then the match doesn't matter.
We just beat the fuck out of each other in that match, and it really put us on the spot as far as grabbing people's attention. And
I'm going through that table on the pod. He's a bloody mess.
At the time, that was the highlight of my life, really. You know, it was, because there's something to be said about being able to take a beating and still stand, or, you know, it's kind of like showing off your scars and your bruises. I remember I'd go back to college and my classmates would be like, what the fuck happened? Like, what did you do over the weekend? I was just, my whole arm would be purple, and I was just, yeah, you know, just, you just get all this pride. I don't, it's fucked. I don't know.